Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel, Thomar Academy. Today we will start new electromagnetic induction and our first topic class is magnetic flux. So magnetic flux through any surface plays in a magnetic field is the total number of magnetic field lines passing through the surface normally, and it is equal to the product of component of magnetic field normal to the surface and surface area. Let's take an example. For example, if I take any surface, we already know the direction of area vector from your chapter 1. Electrostatics, the direction of area vector is perpendicular outward. So let the direction of area vector is in this direction and magnetic field is also in this direction. That means the angle between magnetic field and area vector is 0 degree. So in this case, magnetic flux is equal to just the product of magnetic field and area vector, just be into it. But if for the same surface area vector is still in this direction, but if magnetic field is making certain angle with the area vector, then in this take I can't take just flux as the product of B into A, because in the definition we have taken this word normally. Therefore, we have to resolve this magnetic field into its component. So one component will get along the direction of area vector, which is B cos theta. Another component is B sin theta. So therefore, in this case, your flux will be equal to B cos theta into A. And from our previous knowledge of dot product of vectors and vector product, we know that A dot B is equal to AB cos theta. Therefore, this can be written as B vector dot A vector. And from this formula, we can also say that magnetic flux is the scalar quantity, because dot product of two vectors will give us scalar quantity. But this is a different kind of scalar quantity, because we knew from our previous knowledge the scalar quantity can only be positive, it can't be negative or zero. But here, this scalar quantity, this magnetic flux, can be negative, positive, as well as zero. Why? Because it depends upon the angle between magnetic field and area vector. So for theta exactly equals to 90 degree, your flux will be B into A into cos 90. We know that cos 90 is zero, therefore it is zero. And for theta less than equal to 180 degree, and get the 90 degree, your flux will come out to be negative. And for theta to be greater than or equal to 0 degree and less than 90 degree, your flux will be positive. Clear? So flux is a scalar quantity, but still it can be positive, negative, as well as 0. But what does it mean? What do you mean by positive and negative flux? Positive flux means magnetic field lines are coming out of that surface, similarly as you did for electric flux. And negative magnetic flux means magnetic field lines are coming into the surface. Zero means no magnetic field lines are passing through that surface, or the same number of magnetic field lines are entering and coming out of that surface. Clear? So this is the meaning of zero, negative, and positive magnetic. SI unit, first is Weber, and from the formula, magnetic field ki kya hoti hai? Tesla, and area is meter square. Therefore, we can also write it as Tesla meter square. Now for dimension, how can we find out its dimension? As I told you, dimension can be found out by using formula. But let's say we forgot about the dimension of B, area is L square, but how can we find out B? Therefore, don't do again rectification, just use the concept magnetic field. I'm just using that formula, F is equal to QVB sine theta. So from this formula, I'm just taking out, or I'm just replacing B as F upon QV sin theta and area as it is. So for force, it is MLT minus 2. For charge, it is AT. For velocity, it is LT minus 1. Trigonometric function, no dimension. And for area, it is L square. So on solving, we are getting M as it is. So on solving, we are getting ML2 A minus 1 T minus 2. So this is the introduction part of magnetic flux. Clear? So now we will do Faraday's experiment. In Faraday experiment, he was taking a magnet placed in front of a conducting coil connected with a galvanometer. So when he brought this magnet towards the coil, he found deflection was there. And when he was taking the magnet away from the coil, he again found the deflection, but now in the opposite direction. When the distance between the magnet and the coil was remaining the same, that means there was no change in magnetic field lines passing through the coil, he found the deflection was not there in the galvanometer. Clear? So that means we can say, till the number of magnetic field lines passing through this coil is going to be changed, then only the current will be induced in this coil, provided the coil is closed one. Next case, he repeated all those steps with a greater speed. That means in first case, he was just bringing the magnet at a normal speed towards the coil and he found the deflection was there. In the next case, he was taking the magnet very fast towards the coil and he found the deflection was greater as compared to the previous case, in all the cases. So that means the second conclusion is that the magnitude of current or EMF which is going to be induced in the coil is also depending upon the rate at which magnetic flux is changing. So from this experiment, we can formulate Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction states that whenever magnetic flux linked with a closed circuit varies, EMF is induced in it, which lasts only so long as the variation of flux taking place. This phenomenon is called EMI. First conclusion from the Faraday's experiment. Second one, magnitude of induced EMF is equal to the rate of change of magnetic flux linked with the closed circuit. That means mathematically we can write EMF is equal to minus d phi by dt. What is the meaning of this negative sign? This negative sign is explained by Lenz rule, another law. It states that direction of induced current is such that it always opposes the cause which produces it. Yes, and now, let's take an example to getting it. For example, I am taking a coil and a magnet with the pole north is coming towards the coil. Then what will be the polarity on this coil? So whenever north is going towards this coil, Lenz rule says that it will oppose this cause. And in this case, the cause is the movement of north pole towards the coil. So this will oppose the movement of magnet toward itself, which can be done only by making a north polarity on this face. Therefore, the direction of current on this coil will be anticlockwise. Similarly, if you want to take this magnet again with the north face away from the coil, in this case the cause is north pole is going away from the coil, therefore it will again oppose this cause. So this can be done only by developing here the south one, that means clockwise. This is the meaning of negative sign and the opposition. Clear one? Now, when this Lenz formulated this law, the other physicist said that why the south polarity cannot be developed in this case and north polarity cannot be developed in that case. Why it is so that it is always opposing the cause? So what he did, he just took the help of law of conservation of energy. So he just said that if this is wrong and he said that your concept is correct, that means if north pole is moving towards the coil and he assumed the south polarity is generated. So in that case, we just need the slight displacement of the magnet and therefore south polarity is generating. So now onwards, on its own, this coil will attract the magnet toward itself. That means kinetic energy of the magnet will increase. And this increment in the kinetic energy will be converting into the electrical energy. That means we have created a perpetual machine which is creating its own energy and converting that energy into the work done. So this is a God-made body and this body requires external energy so that then only this body will perform. Therefore, this concept was against the law of conservation of energy. That means we can't have a machine, any machine, which creates its own energy and convert that energy into the useful work done. Therefore, this concept was wrong and whatever the formula was given by Mr. Lenz was following the law of conservation of energy. Hence, we can say that it will always opposes the cause which is going to be producing the current. Let's take some few examples. A reasoning question which usually comes in board examination question on the basis of these laws is give direction of induced current in the coils. So this is a magnetic field, the crossed one. Crossed one means the direction of magnetic field is away from the observer. And these I have taken certain coils which are moving like this along these arrows. So this is moving into it, moving out of it. And the condition with this circular coil is that it will remain only within this magnetic field region. So now we have to use Faraday's laws and the Lenz rule also to give the direction of induction. So first by using Fleming's right hand rule. Now let's take this case. So this coil is moving into it So this is force, magnetic field and electric current. FBI, in short, aap aise rakh lena. FBI, F for force, B for magnetic field, I for current. But do take care, we always apply this rule on the closer part of the coil. Closer means which is closer to the magnetic field. Otherwise, the direction ulta aa jayega. So let's take here. So here I'm just taking, magnetic field is inward. So my forefinger is inward into the board. Thumb will be downward. So current is moving upward. Clear? So therefore, current is moving like this. So just complete this part. And we can say the current is in anti-clockwise manner. Take this example. Now this one is moving out of this region. So again, current will definitely be induced in it. So we will apply this time on this part of this coil. So here, the magnetic field is inward. Force is again the downward gaze and current slightly upward. So here is the direction of current. Here. In this case, again, apply on this part because it is the closer to the magnetic field. So here, force is towards me. Magnetic field is here and the current is like this. In this case, in this direction. Here. So here, the direction of current is clockwise. So this is how we can use Fleming's right hand rule to give the direction of induced current. What will happen in this case of circle ring? Since it is in motion, but it is lying only within this magnetic field region. Therefore, the number of magnetic field lying through this coil will always remain the same. And we knew from the law that current will definitely be induced only if there is change in the magnetic flux. So therefore, in this case, no current will be induced if it is moving or at rest, but still remain inside this uniform magnetic field region. Clear? Now, the next part of this question is determine the same direction of induced current by using Lenz rule. Clear? Lenz rule apply karke dekhte hain isme. Sure. So Lenz rule says it will always oppose the cause. So first try to understand the cause of induced current in this case. So this coil is moving into it. Therefore, the cause is increment in this crossed magnetic field. Jo andar ja raha hai, usme increment ho raha hai. So oppose kya karega wo? Is cross ko decrease karne ki koshish karega. Cross ko ulta kya hota hai? Dot one. Therefore, to decrease this cross, it will try to increase dot one. So dot magnetic field will try to increase. Dot magnetic field means coming towards you, and towards the observer means north pole. North pole means anti-clockwise, which we got by using Fleming's right hand rule. Clear? So now in this case also we'll apply. This triangular coil is moving out of it. That means in this case the cause is decrement in the magnetic field. That means decrement in the cross. So it will try to increase those crosses. So increase kara lete hain. Increase in the cross which is away from the observer, that means clockwise. Clockwise means ye fir aage gira. Again same aa raha dono law se. Here also we can apply. Again the cause is decrement in the cross magnetic field. Therefore here again it will try to increase it by putting more cross into it. More cross again means south polarity. South polarity means clockwise. So this is how we can give the direction of induced current in any of the coil by using Fleming's right hand rule and Lenz. This Lenz rule also have certain application in our daily life also, which I already told you, apply your physics in daily life. So aap metro use karte hain, to wahan par jaise metro station mein enter karte hain, there is a gate. So whenever you pass that gate, there is always a sound beep aata hai wahan pe, hai na? Aur wahan pe ek pointer laga hota hai, wahan pe jo LED lage to usme number bhi increase ho jata hai. To sound kyun aata hai? Ya fir kai bar bolte hain metal detector hota hai wahan pe. To whenever you cross it, metal detector bhi aata hai wahan pe. तो आपने फोटो में देखो, दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ अ मेटल डिटेक्टर. अगेन इट इज बेस्ड ऑन लेंस रूल. लेंस रूल लग गया आपको यहाँ पे. सिमिलरली कार्ड रीडर, कार्ड भी यूज करते हैं हम. कार्ड रीडर में भी यूज होता है ये. माइक्रोफोन में भी यूज होता है. एंड इलेक्ट्रिक ब्रेक इन ट्रेन्स में भी यूज होता है. देखो इधर. So there are so many different applications of Lenz rule in our daily life also. Clear? Now explain this phenomenon in this video. Sanha video mein kya ho raha tha? In that video, humne ek metallic container liya tha, metallic pipe liya tha, aur usme se magnet ko fall karaya tha. And this metallic tube was not magnetic. So usme attraction hone ka koi matlab nahi tha. So usme se jaise usme se ja raha tha, उसका जो मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स है उसमें वेरिएशन आया, वेरिएशन की वजह से उसमें इंड्यूस करंट डेवलप हो गया, एंड इंड्यूस करंट ऑलवेज अपोजेस द कॉज, एंड द कॉज वाज डाउनवर्ड मूवमेंट ऑफ दैट मैग्नेट. दैट इज व्हाई देयरफॉर द मैग्नेट वाज मूविंग वेरी स्लोली थ्रू दैट वायर. क्लियर? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट योर फैराडेज लॉज एंड सर्टेन एग्जांपल्स एंड इन एग्जांपल्स फ्रॉम डेली लाइफ ऑल्सो. सो नाउ लेट्स डू फ्यू न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑल्सो. हेट कर दो ना, पर थोड़ा सा न्यूमेरिकल करते हैं. चलो लेट्स डू इट. The magnetic flux through a coil perpendicular to plane is varying according to this given relation. Calculate induced current through the coil at 3 second if resistance of the coil is 10 ohm. We know that from our knowledge that mod of EMF is equal to d phi by dt. We already know the differentiation also, which we did in our previous class. So t cube, the differentiation is 3t square. So on differentiating, we will get 9t square plus 4t, differentiation of t will give us 1 and differentiation of 10 is 0. So this is our EMF at any time t. But we've been asked to find out the induced current at particular time 3 seconds. So EMF at 3 seconds. So at 3 seconds, EMF is equal to, by putting the values, we are getting 92 volt. And current is equal to EMF divided by R, that means 92 divided by resistance is 10. So current is 9.2 ampere. Clear? Easy numerical है, है ना? Easy to understand. तो पहला numerical है easy. Second थोड़ा सा level बढ़ा देना. Next numerical है, a coil of mean area 1000 centimeter square and having 500 turns is held perpendicular to a uniform magnetic field of 0.5 gauss. The coil is turned through 180 degree in 1 by 10 seconds. Calculate average induced EMF. So we know that there are so many different formulas for EMF. First, we can write E is equal to minus d phi by dt, which we can't apply here. पिछले वाले example में देखा था. यहाँ पर क्या हो सकता है? E is equal to, and in case if there are n turns, then this formula can also be written as n times d phi by dt. But again, this formula cannot be used in this case. So I can use this as delta d phi as delta phi upon delta t, which can be written as phi 2 minus phi 1 upon the change in time interval. So for such kind of numerical, we can use this kind of formula. Clear? So first we'll calculate initial magnetic flux, which is phi 1 equals to B into A. Angle between them is initially 0 degree. So it is just B into A. Next magnetic flux will be B into A cos 180 degree. Question mein likha tha 180 degree se turn kar diya. So now it will be minus BA. So change in magnetic flux is phi 2 minus phi 1. That will give us minus 2 times BA, and EMF will be equal to minus N delta phi by delta T. That means this will become 2 times N BA divided by delta T. Now we just check ki data given hai ya nahi. N given hai 500 tons. B, this is also given to us 0.5 gauss. Area, this is also given to us 1000 centimeter square. Delta T is also giving us as 1 by 10 second. So just you just put the values and get the respective answer in volt. So you calculate karna hai ghar pe, aur iska jo answer hai mere comments mein dalna, then I'll tell you ki answer correct hai ki nahi. Itna to homework karenge na, to ye ghar pe karna. Theek hai? So that's all for today. So in today's class, what we did, we just tried to understand what is electromagnetic induction, Faraday's laws, their conclusions, their formula, and then Lenz rule. Lenz rule ke ek reasoning question kiya. फिर उसमें आपने डेली लाइफ में भी देखा कि लेंस रूल कहां कहां पे लगता है, देखा था ना, याद रहेगा, और भी डेली लाइफ में लगाओ, देन टू न्यूमेरिकल्स, और ऐसी एप्लीकेशन डेली लाइफ में भी करो, रीजनिंग क्वेश्चन ट्राई करो और ऐसे न्यूमेरिकल्स भी ट्राई करो. ठीक है? एग्जाम में बहुत आता है, बोर्ड एग्जाम में बहुत ज्यादा क्वेश्चन आ सकते हैं. ठीक है? सो मिलते हैं फिर अगली वीडियो में. टिल देन कीप अप्लाइंग योर फिजिक्स इन डेली लाइफ. जय हिंद, जय भारत.